Okay, so I need working on the armature here. I need shoulders, I need elbows, and I need feet, which are down here. And I got two pieces of brass, and I don't have my grinder. I think I might have left it in my truck when it broke down. Or I don't know, my brother might have borrowed it, but I called him up and I tried to borrow his, and he didn't have it. So I think I'm just gonna try it anyway and just try to get these pieces made and use a file instead, which is gonna be kind of a pain, but I really want to just keep this going. And I just, if I can just get enough made to finish out this puppet, then it'll be good. So. Okay, so the way I do this is I tape the two pieces together. As you can see, I wrapped a little tape around there, and then I mark it 1 inch a piece because each socket is 1 inch all the way to the end. So I have 1, 2, 3. So I'm gonna make 12 of these. Okay, so then I go ahead and I measure out center on every single one. So the center is a half inch, of course, and I make dots all the way. And then I drill those, and those are the center holes. So I use this little bit right here to cap all the holes. Alright, so there you go. All of those are drilled. Those are the center holes, and one side will be capped, and then the other side will be made bigger for the screw. So then what I do is I use like a template. This is one that just got messed up. I ground it a little bit too fine. And I set it on the hole. That, and then I just come along and I mark the centers. All right, so I did the same thing again, did all the pilot holes. I'm gonna use this bigger one to do the bigger holes. And the space between these two, like from the center screw out to the hole, it should be 5/16 also. And I think like these bigger holes are, let me see what this is. This one's a 13/32. They don't have to be exact though. You just got to figure out what works for you. And what I do is I actually just grab a piece of sandpaper and clean up the holes on both sides. And I was going to say that like this thing with the taping them together, it's important to keep them like taped in the same configuration or mark it in some way that you can get it back together, because each of the holes, it's like not exact. So like each one's sort of like a custom match, and that can kind of be a pain, but it's just the way this way works out. I know this ain't the most pro way, but that's how I do it. Yeah, it looks a lot better. It doesn't take much, it's just a little bit, but you want to knock off all the burrs and stuff, because you don't want them to dig into like one of the balls and make a nick in it, and then the ball doesn't, turn smooth. So one side of this has to be capped, so like all the center holes have to be capped with like a cap, so the screws can hold it together, see what I mean? And then the other side's free, like this side's actually free, and then the screw goes into this side. So then like I'm going to cap all these holes, and then when I go back here I'll have to drill these the middle ones out bigger. So when you tap these things, how you do it is you go like a half turn back, and then you do, about a half turn forward. And then you go back, and then you go forward again a little bit, and then you go back. Why you do that is if you just went screwing in there full blast, so now I just went through, so I'm just going forward. Then you would, you'd break the tap, because the metal needs some place to go to get out of there. And now I could use one of these little screws to hold it, see what I mean? Goes right in there. So I just go through and I tap all the center holes. Okay, so here we go. So I'll line back up. All the center holes are tapped, so then I'm gonna flip this one over, and I gotta drill out the center holes on this one with the bigger bit. So I hate to say it, but I don't have my saw that can cut metal either, so I'm just going to hacksaw off the ones I need and go from there. So I'll see you guys in a minute or two. Focus up, camera. So okay, so anyway, now I've got them, two sandwich pieces with the screw and I'm gonna round the edges so that the thing doesn't bind up like the threaded rod that comes out of the ball. So I'm gonna do that with the vise and with the file. Doesn't take much. Just take that edge off. It actually isn't that tough to do this. It's not like hours and hours of filing. I only file a couple minutes or a minute. Because the brass is like such a soft metal. And then I usually take my sandpaper and just kind of clean it up while it's in the vise. Then you just flip it. You got it like that. And do it again. Do all the four corners. Alright, that's what you end up with. And you just do the next one. Oh, yeah. They're kind of hard to get together when there's no like rod attached to the balls, but there you go. That's a finished one. Just cut that off the hacksaw. I'm good to go. So I'm out here doing this. This is the back of the head with the magnets, and I'm gonna need to put a ball like right there. So a ball sinks in 3/16, so I'm gonna cut that off a little bit longer than that with the hacksaw, and we'll put a ball on there. There we go. There's a piece cut off, and I probably need to hit that with a little sandpaper, because when you cut like a piece of threaded rod, it kind of messes the threads up a little bit. So there we go, just like that.
Okay, so I have all the pieces for the armature done. Excuse my voice, kind of losing my voice, but anyway, I'm gonna put it together and see what it looks like. There's the leg. There's the torso. Sick this week. It's crazy. We were all sick. It's like Tristan's sick and Tanya's sick, and it's like right before Thanksgiving, and it's just brutal. Anyway, I wanted to show you some improvements I made to the armature that I didn't really tell you guys about while I was making it. Right here, as you can see on the ankles, I put in two pieces of brass rod, which, you know, I have a hole drilled out there, but I don't need it. And the next time around, imagine I'll either just use a flat piece or see if I can get some double. Because, you know, I just noticed the armature was just not quite as sturdy as I wanted. And now it is super sturdy. It could just stand on one fit and do like everything I needed to do. I also doubled it on the knees. I doubled it on the, what joints would these be? Pelvis joints? I don't know. Top of the leg joints. Doubled it in the center joint right here, and then that's it. I left these alone, and also the neck, because it's like they move fine and they don't hold a ton of weight like these things do, especially the ankles. Second thing I did was, if you remember, I actually had like two sockets here, and then I had the arms coming out. And I started looking around online, and I just noticed like there was a lot of puppets, like even like the Paranorman puppets and really nice puppets that Leica uses. They only have one joint. So I went ahead and I took out that joint, and I just kept this one, and I like it a lot better. Because you can still kind of get a shoulder shrug out of it, you know. And the only thing that I kind of wish I'd have done is made this a little wider, so shoulders could have been wider, but it doesn't matter so much, because like this puppet wears this crazy thing that covers the shoulders. So I also had two joints in the neck, and I ended up taking one out. Ended up deciding that I just didn't need it. I like how the neck moves better. And it brought my whole puppet down a smidge. And kind of just gave it the proportions I want. Anyway, this stuff here is actually epoxy, which I just built up over the brass rod. And I actually epoxied in the balls, which I know that's not the pro way. You know, it's like the pro way is to solder it. I use this stuff. And I'll tell you, the reason I did it was the last armature, my nephew and I tried to solder all the balls, and it was just a real pain, and I kept having them break. The ones that broke, I actually used this stuff. It's PC7 epoxy paste. And I mean, it's like that crazy, you know, metal epoxy that just sticks to any damn thing and hardens up like rock. Like you can fix gas tanks with it and all this kind of crazy stuff. And it works well. I mean, they're good. They're in there, and you know, I might regret it later. But this is a build-up puppet, so like, you know, if things start breaking, I can take them apart. You know, so I'm gonna try it this way. I don't know if it's the best way. Maybe on the next one we'll try to really, you know, solder it and all that, but I just kind of wanted it together. I wanted to go for it. I wanted to get this guy done, and I wanted to get the next one done, so. So I actually just threw on some clothes on this guy from my other puppet, just to kind of get scale of this dude, you know. And I think I like it. I just filmed some like great stuff and I lost it. That drives me crazy. You know, this camera, it doesn't have like a dedicated button to film, so sometimes I'll push it and I'll think it's going and it'll just focus. I wanted to just kind of wrap up because I've been getting some comments. A lot of comments sort of like asking me how to do this, asking me how to do that, and really treating my videos like tutorials. And I'm not like a genius at stop motion, and I'm not a guy who's worked at like a studio for like, you know, 20 years or something. I'm just a dude who like, you know, has like started this crazy thing on my own in my room in my little trailer. And I'm just trying it, you know, I'm just going for it. And everything I've learned, I've kind of like just learned on the internet. So some things I've learned wrong, I'm sure, and I'm sure that some things, you know, I'm doing right. So I didn't want to, you know, come off like, you know, I'm a genius at stop motion and this is the way to do it. It's like, just watch my videos, watch other people's videos. And then, you know, put all that stuff together and like figure it out for yourself, you know, because that's how I do it. So the second thing I was going to say is I've also kind of, you know, I've run across this on the web where it's just people sort of like, I love what you're doing, but I can't do that. You know what I mean? And not only in stop motion, but like in art, you know, because I'm like an independent artist too. You know, I don't have a job. I draw art and I sell it. And I sell it like on eBay and private clients and things like that, you know. So it's like a struggle, but I make it work, you know. And I wanted to say, like, to, like, all those people, you know, that, like, you can actually do it, you know, and you not only can do it, but you should do it, because when I look around the web, you know, I find so many people that, like, inspire me. Some guys, like, this guy named Ishamahawk, he does, like, Robin videos, or no, Nightwing videos. And he gets a ton of hits on his channel, and you know, he's making it independently with something that he just started with him and his friends. There's another guy, Freddie Wong, and I've always been just a super fan of this guy. He makes just gunfight videos. His channel is called Rocket Jump, and it's like you know, the same thing. He's like progressed and gotten better, and over time gotten really good at it, and now he's actually making like movies for the net. I think he's got a series on Hulu called Video Game High School, and that was actually on YouTube first. So, you know, he ran a Kickstarter. It's not so much he got a bunch of money, he learned how to do it first, you know what I mean. He started making stuff, he started putting videos up, then he got bigger and bigger and bigger, and the YouTube channel grew and his AdSense grew, and you know, now he's massive. That's super inspiring, because he was just a guy that was like, you know, with his friends running around like the backyard, like shooting at each other, you know, and filming it. there's another guy that just blows my mind. His name's Patrick Bovin, and he does, like, stop-motion toy animation. If you're into stop-motion, like, I know some people, just, they aren't into the toy animation, they're not into Lego animation, but this guy is somebody to watch. He has just massive, massive, massive subscribers. I think I just pulled up his video, the Bruce Lee one, and, where is it? Dang it, did I shut that window? I can't find it, but, I think it had 19 million hits. Which, that just sounds crazy, just saying that. I'm like, no, that can't be right. 19 million hits, I mean, that's, like, bigger than the biggest YouTube. He's basically, like, playing with, like, toys, if you really want to break it down. Anybody could go buy Iron Man and Bruce Lee toys. Anybody could animate that stuff, because it's animated in his apartment, you know? He's really fucking good at it, but when you really get down to it, it's something that anybody can do. And he's uploading them himself, you know? It just shows what can happen, you know? So if you want to do your, like, stop-motion movie, or you want to do your short, or you want to do, you know, your indie comic, it's like, fucking do it. Do it, like, right now. Because, like, now's the time. It's never been better, you know? The gatekeepers are gone. We got YouTube, we got Vimeo, we got access to an audience. And that is freaking awesome. Anyway, thanks for watching the video, guys. Subscribe if you haven't. Don't miss them. Stop motion videos go out every Friday. Artcast go out on Mondays, and the Artcasters live chat with Kevin Cross and Scott Circland and myself are every Wednesday. Thanks a lot, guys, and I'll see you next time.